Alright, nice station on all of the birds. Good length them up across the board. This one's lacking a little bit of performance here. Also, feels like it's got just a little bit smaller body than a couple of the others. So I'm gonna go 4 on this cock here. I'll walk out my beautiful back line on this bird here. Carriage is good. Globes, both of the blues have nice globes. On the white, globe's good. Not quite as finished in the feather. Probably another month this bird's going to be finished out a little bit better. I think the one thing in the white that I see as a tendency is bit long, a little bit longer in the back end. But all three of them have nice power for young birds. Another thing that's really difficult in managing in the big muff birds is making sure that you got layering. All three birds really layer off nice. They all have beautiful muffs. Come right up to the hawk. One thing that's catching me a little bit off on the white is on its one wing, you want to hold it up a little bit more than the others, so wanting to cross that. If that power transitioned right down through, you'd have a little bit more closed back. We're seeing a little bit of it still on this bird as well, a little bit more exaggerated here. I think in another month, when this bird finishes out the molts, I think it's going to be a little bit more mature and probably going to be a different pigeon by then. Today I'll go 3 on the white. And I'm going to go 2 on the blue in the middle, primarily because in the front, the coloring is, markings are a little bit off, it's a little bit bleeding down. Markings are still a big part of the breed. You have a little bit better mark on here, the two blues are really similar. Both have nice power, big shoulders. I'm going to go 1 and 2. Yeah.